Carob is a leguminous fruit tree, and it has been cultivated since ancient times in most countries of the Mediterranean area. Spain, Italy, Greece, Turkey, Cyprus, Morocco, Algeria, and Tunisia, and also in Portugal, these countries being its main producers. Arabians called the carob seed karat, which originated the name kirat, word used since the Middle Ages for measuring precious material. Carob was also used for making some marmalades, and its leaves were applied for tanning leather. The first works and information on this Mediterranean fruit tree date from the end of the 19th century and the beginning of the 20th. At the 1980s, research was started on this crop in some Mediterranean countries. In Spain, the carob crop is concentrated along the Mediterranean coast. Spain is the world's main carob producer, about 70 to 80,000 tons of carobs yearly. The regular crop surface is about 75,000 hectares, and the main regions are Valencia, 35,000 hectares, Balearic Islands, 14,600 hectares, Catalonia, 10,500 hectares, Andalusia, 3,600 hectares, and Murcia, 1,000 hectares. Existing also about 100,000 scattered trees growing wild associated with other species, like almonds, olives, figs, and grapes. Carob's considerable rusticity and the rise of carob pot prices, together with its adaptation to part-time agriculture, have increased the interest in new orchards because of its high productivity. Increasing its yield will make this crop to be considered as a renewed alternative for some rainfall soils or in poor soils with scarce hydric resources along the Mediterranean coast. It should also be considered that in several Spanish producing regions, such as the Balearic Islands and Andalusia, the carob tree has been used for forest recovering of farming soils, with the support to the autonomies established by the communitarian agrarian policies. We know that carob grows well in areas along the coast, with a scarce frost incidence and on altitudes below 600 meters above sea level. Temperatures below 4 Celsius degrees may damage the tender leaves of young trees, and also the inflorescences of adults, although the carob tree stands high summer temperatures up to 45 Celsius degrees, and dry hot winds. The tree is sensitive to high humid environments at blooming time. This process takes place from August to November. Also, strong winds on the coast may cause branch breakage and important green pod drop. Carob is not demanding on soil conditions. It adapts well to calcareous soils, alkaline pH, stony, and often with hydrate deficits. Heavy soils, badly drained, are not suitable for this crop, as they cause chlorosis to the trees. Production level depends mostly on the availability of water and soil deepness, obtaining good harvest with rainfall around 500 mm per year. Cultivars are located in their native zones, and they are rarely found anywhere else. Thus, in Catalonia stand out Negra, Rujal, Costella de Ruc, and Banya de Cabra. In Comunitat Valenciana, Matalafera, Negra, Malera, and Lindar. On the island of Mallorca, Bugadera, Durayó, and Dalamel. In Murcia, de Mullar, and in Andalusia, Sayalonga. And a population of seeding trees called Bravia is outstanding. Among the hermaphrodite types, the cultivar Ramillete should be mentioned, which is mainly grown in Murcia. Most of these cultivars have a low median kernel yield, 8 to 14%, although with some of them, as the Bravia type, yields are higher, ranging from 16 to 18%. At world level, the carob cultivars from Morocco should be pointed out, as their rich seed yields around 18 to 20%. And the Portuguese cultivars, Alhosa, Mulata, and Aida, for their carob gum yield and quality. Irta Mas Bové, located in Constantí, Tarragona, has introduced to its germoplast bank the main Spanish and foreign cultivars, with a total amount of 218 cultivars.
Estem a l'IRTA, Mas de Bover, Constantí, Tarragona. Aquest centre va començar a treballar amb el garrofer a partir dels anys 80 en temes relacionats amb el material vegetal, tècniques de conreu i qualitat de la garrofa. Actualment hi ha 160 varietats provenients de 10 països diferents, la majoria d'ells a la conca mediterrània, com pot ser Espanya, Itàlia, Portugal, Marroc, Grècia, etc. I també n'hi ha alguns fora d'ella, com pot ser Califòrnia i Austràlia. En aquest banc de germoplasma se fan una sèrie d'estudis relacionats amb temes agronòmics, com l'entrada en producció, potencial productiu, el vigor, la tolerància a plagues d'infermetats, i en quant al fruit se fan les característiques de la polpa i també s'estudia també el contingut en goma i la qualitat d'aquesta a nivell industrial.
Rain-fed field plots have been made with four Spanish cultivars from different origins: Rujal, Banya de Cabra, Matalafera and Durelló. The results of these trials have indicated that the cultivars Rujal and Durelló have the shortest unbearing time and the largest harvest. Also, Durelló is outstanding because of its bigger seed production that makes it commercially more interesting. Traditional varieties have a high pulp content as main characteristic, used for animal feeding like horses, and a low kernel yield, 8-10%. From the seed or kernel, the carob gum is extracted into flour, important natural thickening agent because of its high quality, used in the food industry, ice cream, sauces, creams, mayonnaises. Carob gum is a food additive, now in the European Union by the code E410. Crop blooming period is characterized by its long duration, from September to November, mainly in female and hermaphrodite trees. Pollination is important in this crop, and in commercial orchards the presence of male and or hermaphrodite pollinators is required, with a percentage of 10-12%. Bees and flies are the main pollen vectors, apart from the wind, obtaining higher quality beam with this percentage of pollinators. A singular aspect of this tree is the coincidence of blooming and harvesting in September. Some losses are produced while harvesting due to flower drop, as branches are shaken or knocked to collect the carob pods from the tree. Also, it is advisable to use more than one pollinator, male or hermaphrodite, to cover completely the stigma's receptivity period of the main female cultivars, and thus reduce the risk of not overlapping blooms. Multiplication of carob is traditionally done by seed, budding the tree afterwards in the orchard with a chosen cultivar. Two kinds of plantlets are used: plants 1 or 2 years old without budding, transplanted with plastic pot. This is the most used system, and in good conditions it can be budded on the second year after planting, being the best time to do it in the month of April or May. The most used methods are T-budding, plantlets of about 1 or 2 cm, and patch budding above 2 cm diameter. Budded plants with 1 year old bud in plastic pot is the best selection, although not common in the nurseries as quality plantlets are scarce and they are very expensive. Nevertheless, it is advisable to use quality plants to achieve uniform and early producing orchards. In order to reduce the cost of plants, at IRTA Mas de Bover, Constantí, studies are being carried out on self-rooting hardwood cuttings. Once the cultivar has been chosen, hardwood is taken between February and April, and they are treated with growth hormones, indobutyric acid, to get a good rooting. Also, in some commercial nurseries, carob propagation in vitro has been started. Currently, agronomic advantages of these new propagation systems are being studied. it is advisable to plant carob trees at the end of the winter to avoid frost risks, and usually from pot size 50 cm tall directly into the holes, without cutting them. During the first growing year, some irrigation should be made to help rooting. Also, it is important to use stakes to protect the grafts from the wind and to ease their vertical growth. Planting distances are variable and can range from 20 per 20 meters up to 15 per 15 meters, that is about 25 to 45 trees per hectare in traditional carob orchard, although in modern orchards about 200 trees per hectare can be reached, 8 meters per 7 meters, 8 meters per 6 meters, reducing the planting space and always taking into consideration the vigor and longevity of the species and soil characteristics of the new plantation. Carob pruning is less important than in other Mediterranean trees, such as olive or almond, as fructification takes place on all branches more than 2 years old, and therefore it consists in leaving 3 or 4 main branches at a height of not less than 0.8 meters from the ground, in order to facilitate the mechanization of the crop. A light training is recommended over the first years. After the first fructification, reduced pruning is made at the canopy, and gradually low branches are removed, until the final height of the trunk's first scaffold is reached. This operation is done at the beginning of autumn. In case big branches are removed, mastic should be applied. In old trees, pruning is usually carried out every 3 or 4 years to contribute to the distribution of light into the canopy and to control yearly production. Mechanical tillage for carob should not be deeper than 15 to 20 cm to prevent harming the tree root system. 3 or 4 more operations with cultivator are made to remove weeds. Today, in some modern orchards, specific herbicide products are applied under the tree canopies, and also green covers between rows, in order to make harvesting mechanization easier. Studies have shown that this Mediterranean leguminous tree is unable to fix atmospheric nitrogen, and thus it depends on its incorporation to the soil. And although traditionally carobs were not fertilized, today farmers tend to introduce some kind of mineral fertilizer in their orchards. It should be considered that under rainfall conditions, mineral fertilizers do not achieve their beneficial effects, and they do under irrigated conditions. Although the carob tree is very rustic, it might be affected by several pests and some atmospheric accidents, such as color wind. Among the most important pests should be mentioned the leopard moth, the carob moth, and the white scale, and also the country rat. The following diseases should be pointed out. Mildew and Polysporus sulfurius can destroy branches in old trees. To control mildew, preventive treatments are made in March and in October, and in some young irrigated orchards, important attacks of black aphids have been observed, especially on tender shoots of some cultivars. The carob pod harvest is carried out at the end of summer and the beginning of autumn, according to cultivars and zones. Harvesting can be done by hand or mechanically. In traditional orchards, the carob pod is harvested mainly by knocking them with sticks and poles, putting a net below the tree to collect the pods, or also it is collected using plastic nets on the ground, after blow cleaning the leaves from the soil. This process should be done carefully, as at this time of the season, blooming is common, so if the inflorescences fall down, this will reduce the next crop. Mechanized harvesting with a shaker applied on trunks or main branches is done in some modern orchards, as they were designed for this purpose. After harvesting the carob pods using rakes, they are collected by hand or harvested using vacuum machines. Other methods are being experimented using sweepers and pickup machines from the soil, previously cleaned using blowers similar to those using hazelnut. In order to deliver clean carob pods at the cooperative or industries, orange fruit cleaners are being used currently, as in olive and hazelnut. Then the sample's kernel yield should be recorded in order to evaluate economically the samples with most seed content. When the carob pod arrives at the processing industry, it is crushed mechanically using a cleaver and it is separated from the kernel. The pulp is mainly destined to animal feed, although the industry for human dietetics is increasing its consumption lately, such as chocolates, bakery products or pastry. The carob kernel is sold to the additive industries, where the flour or carob gum is removed from the endosperm and used as food thickening agent. Carob is considered to be a late-bearing tree crop, from 6 to 8 years after grafting. Although new orchards applying light pruning and improving its management, bearing precocity is increased around the 4th or 5th year after grafting, according to the cultivar used. From IRTA, Mas Bové, potential bearing of some new orchards is evaluated, such as the cultivars Rujal and Durayó, which both achieve early bearing at the 3rd or 4th year after grafting, under support irrigation of rain-fed conditions with about 500 mm of rainfall. On the 10th year, orchards with density of 100 to 150 trees per hectare reached average crop productions of 5,000 kg hectare under rain-fed conditions, and with irrigation about 7,000 kg per hectare. Thus, the high bearing capacity of these modern orchards is clear, in comparison with those traditional, only rain-fed orchards, with having 45 trees per hectare, the best-drained trees reaching only an average yield of 2,000 to 3,000 kg per hectare. Carob is a Mediterranean fruit tree, and its fruit, the carob pod, has multiple applications, especially for animal feed, carob pulp, and human food, through transformation of its seed, the carob kernel. It is an alternative crop for certain rain-fed areas along the Mediterranean coast, and it is an interesting option in landscape and environmental uses of land, which also confers in a high ecologic value, apart from its high yield as an alternative crop in some Mediterranean areas with scarce hydric resources.